Good morning, Super Ninfriendos, and welcome to a very special live episode of Nintendo Voice Chat, episode 700. And we just watched the Pokemon Presents all 14 minutes of it. Everyone woke up early. Joshua drove across LA. Anyway, I am Seth Macy. I am joined by IGN's Elite Three trainers, Reb Valentine.
I'm still processing what I just saw.
Joshua Yale, who appears to be having some sound issues at the moment, but trust me, he is here. And Miranda Sanchez. And you might see one of Miranda's cats.
Hi, good morning. Yes, there is one in the background. You'll see probably later. She's sleeping because it is very early on the West Coast.
It's very early on the West Coast. But I appreciate that you all woke up to be here for a Pokemon Presents that was literally 13 minutes long. But let's get right into it. But first, I'm sorry, I have to do a little housekeeping. So, and I copy-pasted the wrong part. While I've got you, I wanted to shout out our pals at Humble Bundle, where you can regularly grab a ton of great games for dirt cheap, and the proceeds go towards supporting great causes. Right now, Humble is teaming up with IGN to offer 20 lucky IGN readers a chance to win Humble Choice memberships for 12 months. Head over to humblebundle.com/bundle to grab some games today. And then I also have a part about FanFest to get you access to a ton of awesome giveaways and great deals you won't find anywhere else. Excuse me, this is IGN Rewards. Right now, in collaboration with StarForge Systems and 11th Hour Games, IGN Rewards members have the opportunity to win a custom Last Epoch PC. Oh, that's kind of dope. Additionally, IGN Rewards, even for me, it's early. Additionally, IGN Rewards provides access to more giveaways, including the chance to win a free MetaQuest, a Steam Deck, Xbox, and PS5 controllers, plus much more. Signing up is completely free and takes just a moment, so simply head over to IGN.com/rewards. Okay. Fortunately, we have lost Joshua for the time being, but again, we're doing a live show, and it's kind of crazy. It's kind of wild. So let's talk about the early morning Pokemon Presents, and I'm going to open up conversation. Reb,
you're killing me, Seth!
Do you feel like it was worth waking up this early?
I 90% no, but the ending was really interesting. I'm still like we literally just finished, and I haven't like read the discourse. I haven't gotten to watch it back yet. I'm still processing what that
we
last
thing
was.
We
are the discourse. Like, yeah. The final reveal, I guess it's called Pokemon Legends ZA. Is that what we're going with? I don't.
Yeah.
Zah? Pokemon yeah. Legends Zah? Because, like, there were so many. Yeah, if you remember the conversation, I think we talked about this on the show, like, not that long ago. We were talking about how after Pokemon X and Y came out, there were all these rumors that there was going to be a Pokemon Z, and then there never was. And then a lot of the Zygarde stuff got sort of repurposed into a later game. And now there were, again, like, rumors that we were going to get some sort of Pokemon Legends game. Maybe it was going to be Black and White. We didn't know. So this is interesting. So it's Kalos region. That's what we're doing. This is not what anyone thought we were getting.
No. Well, all right.
Well, I actually called this because, you know, Pokemon.
Never mind. Joshua thought we were getting this.
Welcome back, Joshua.
Pokemon Z, it's obviously it was Pokemon Za all along, which is short for pizza, which is from Italy, which is near France. and Lumio City is based on, you know, Paris. So it all makes sense to me. Come on, right. Guys.
Yeah, it takes out.
We also saw the Mega Evolution symbol. Is that what that was at the very, very tail end? Yeah. So Mega Evolution coming back. I'm into it.
All right.
Just a quick question. Do you guys think this is like a futuristic, like, whereas in our last Legends, it was set in the past. This one looks like it's set in the future.
Yeah. That's a good shout. I think you might be right.
I think the confidential, like, I guess urban redevelopment plan, like, that could be like a futuristic, like, we're making this again, like, we're improving. That could hint at that in a weird way. And I think just like that sort of 3D, we're going in the game, like, intro for it kind of gave me those vibes that they want to do some sort of like revamp. It's like, this is a historic place and now we're going forward. Do you think that's like a potential for this to kind of play with what like the Legends means?
I think you're absolutely right. I wasn't clocking that when I was watching it because I wasn't expecting a Legends Kalos or, name. Yeah. But yeah. I think you're absolutely right. I think the Legend series is going to be defined not specifically by going into the past, but just by time travel in general. And I think that's exactly
right. Well, I was noticing here as we're rewatching the little teaser trailer, the Z has sort of a futuristic grid on it. While the A almost looks organic, like leaves or the woods. So I don't know what that could possibly mean, but we'll find out in 2025, apparently.
Well, Z looking like that is, it's like a Zygarde pattern, right? Because Zygarde is this cellular Pokemon. Like, that's the whole thing around Zygarde. And so it looks kind of like that, but you're right that it has sort of a futuristic tone to it.
Yeah. I want to shout out the logo reveal because it's almost ridiculous because it's Pokemon. And then like two beats, then Legends. You're like, oh, okay. Yep, and then another two beats. Z, all right. And then a hyphen. Probably the best hyphen reveal I've ever seen.
It's like how I imagine they develop game titles at Square Enix. They just keep like adding little bits onto the end over and over again.
Yeah, it's actually in the break room at Square Enix. They just have refrigerator, poetry, magnets, and that's how they name Kingdom Hearts games. But all right, my next question, I mean, we obviously jumped right into this because this is probably the biggest news, out of the Pokemon Presents. But how are we feeling? Do we think this is going to be a Switch title, or do we think this is going to be something coming to the next generation Nintendo console, which apparently is rumored to be not coming out until 2025, just like Pokemon Legends Zah, or Z-A, or Z-A, which is a negative letter. Joshua, what do you think? Do you think we're gonna be seeing this? We're gonna be playing this on our next Nintendo console?
Well, I don't know. This feels like maybe a double dip where it might, because it's coming at the end of the Switch life console. So maybe we'll get it on both. That's the thing they do, right?
Yeah. 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 They did it with Breath of the Wild. They did it with the Zelda game before that. I'm sorry. I'm slightly ill, so I'm having a hard time remembering. But
we were just watching it back, and it did have the Nintendo Switch logo in the top right corner. I mean, that could mean anything. For years, they did the whole, oh, it's the Nintendo 3DS family of systems business. But I think there's no way it doesn't release on the current Nintendo Switch. But I think Joshua's idea that it might be a double dip is not a bad one.
Yeah.
I did want to go back to the Mega Evolution symbol.
Yes.
I don't know if y'all agree with me, but I feel like popular consensus out there in the Pokemon community is that Mega Evolution is probably the high point of Pokemon mechanics, and they've been chasing it ever since, you know, with Dynamax, Gigantamax, and this Terrestrialize, whatever. And honestly, they haven't really hit the same way as Mega Evolution. So the fact that they're returning to that, that's probably the most exciting thing to me, is the return of Mega Evolution, more Pokemon getting Mega Evolutions, maybe even different twists on pre-existing Megas. I don't know, but that is super exciting.
Yeah.
Yeah, I completely agree. Like, it's as you said, a high point in those mechanics for special evolutions or special battle mechanics, and to have those come back. And I didn't even think about it, like, oh yeah, we'll probably get new Mega Forms. Like, there's so many Pokemon now. I mean, it always feels like there's so many Pokemon, but
yeah,
especially since
it's
been developed. So
yeah, Pikachu never got a Mega, or I guess Raichu. Psyduck didn't get one. That's an oversight. You know, none of a lot of the marquee Pokemon did not get a Mega. So I feel like this is the time to go back and correct that mistake.
Yeah,
yes, absolutely.
Go back and write.
I fully agree with all of that. I wanted to talk about it's coming out in 2025.
Yeah,
like that's kind of a big thing in a couple different ways. It means Pokemon is, unless they're going to pull something else out of their back pocket later in the year, which I don't think they are, because they would have shown it here. Like, we don't have a big Pokemon release this year. I think this is our first year in a while where we haven't had a big Pokemon release, which seems like it's good, because the big, you know, we don't know what's going on internally at Game Freak, but one of the big speculations around what, like, the quality level of Scarlet and Violet and some of the other things they've done lately has been that they're not taking enough time to develop these games. So it's awesome that they're taking their time, presumably, and not releasing this till 2025. At the same time, what the heck is coming out on the Switch this holiday if the Switch successor indeed has been delayed to 2025? Like, what's their holiday game?
That's a good question. Metroid Prime 4. Not too early to make jokes.
It shouldn't be on Pokemon to be the holiday game, to be clear. Like, I fully endorse this decision. I just think it's interesting.
Yeah, it is interesting. I did not expect them to... I kind of maybe just expected that this was in development or coming soon, but for them to say, like, a release window of 2025 is very interesting, because this is maybe the first game, Nintendo game, that we know is coming in 2025. And so there is a very good possibility could be, you know, the double dip launch game with whatever the next title is. But yeah, like, Joshua, what are we thinking for the holiday this year? There's no Pokemon. There's nothing. Kids are going to have the worst Christmas ever.
That's okay. Just give me time to replay X and Y, I guess. I have to brush up on my my Gen 6 before this game.
All right. Fair enough. I actually just found my copy again, so maybe I'll go back through it and finish it. But Miranda, what are you thinking? What is the Pokemon future for this year? Is it like we know nothing?
Well, we have Pokemon Sleep updates. So that's exciting.
Let's get Pokemon Sleep. Speak. I know both of you got excited about Sleep, and then Joshua had a great question that I want all of you to answer. Which of the legendaries would you most like to cover? Reb.
Oh, which of the legendaries? Ever that have ever existed?
Sure.
Yeah, sure. Well, in the video, we saw that they're bringing Entei, Raikou, and Suicune, but if not those three, which one would you cuddle?
I mean, of those three, probably Entei, because Suicune seems like it would be cold and wet, and Raikou seems a little sharp. But I think Mew would be nice to cuddle with, actually. Small, soft, cute.
Yeah. Soft? It looks slimy.
What?
Mew, it's a cat.
Mew slimy. I've never
thought Mew looks slimy. Mew too is like a genetic.
That's
like
a different Pokemon, Joshua.
But they're from one and the same. You think he's a cat? You think he has fur? No, that's like skin. He's like one of those naked DNA.
He's like a Sphinx cat. Yeah.
Those are nice too. Sphinx cat. What's wrong with a hairless cat?
Yeah, you get to give them like little lotion massages and stuff. Like, I think like you have to like bathe them specially, and they have to have little hoods and coats. Maybe
this
Mew
is
also
Pokemon hate.
Okay, well, I am not giving Mew a lotion bath, okay? Reb, I actually have to check in with you. While we were watching, pretty much, you know, every 5 seconds were screaming, let's go Johto? You were like, oh, is that Johto music? That's a Johto Pokemon.
Oh, yeah.
And it didn't happen. Why did you think that was coming, and how do you feel that it was not a part of this presents?
So I am tentatively excited for this Legends game, despite the fact that we have not seen any gameplay, I will point out. Zero gameplay, zero anything. That said, this was massive Johto bait. Like, at every second, they're putting the three legendary dogs from Johto in Pokemon Sleep. They're playing music from Generation 2, Gold, Silver, Crystal, in like the little interstitials between announcements. They were showing the unknown repeatedly, which, by the way, I need someone to tell me what those unknown at the end said, because I think my unknown reading abilities have gotten rusty. It was like, something? I can't read unknown. Anyway, like, they showed Silver in Pokemon, whatever the trainer game is. I've just lost it. Masters? Silver was in that. There was just Johto stuff all over this presentation. And one of the big rumors we've heard, apart from Pokemon Black and White remakes, is a Pokemon, a Let's Go Johto, basically. Like, Let's Go Pikachu and Eevee, but with, I don't know, like, Pichu and Togepi or something. I have no idea. And that's not what we got. And that's fine. They can make whatever they want. But it was really weird to tease this thing that people have been so excited about, seemingly, and then just not do it.
Also, like, at the end of Pokemon Let's Go, there is a little reference to, like, your heart and soul and stuff. And so it's like, hey, the next one. I'm like, yeah, that sounds great. I want to go back there. And to Rep's point, too, like, even looking at Pokemon Sleep, which I know we keep going back to, and I was like, yeah, I wish I was still playing Pokemon Sleep right now, but, you know, I'm not.
I wish I was sleeping.
We're here instead. We could be playing a game in our sleep. But these are our first legendaries, and for it to be, like, Johto legendary specifically is so pointed that it's just a little weird. Like, we,
yeah. I guess of all the legendaries, those are the ones that are, like, I guess best suited to sleeping, right? Like, the legendary birds wouldn't make, I mean, they would, you could do birds.
Yeah, I mean, you,
birds roost.
You sleep with rocks. Sleep.
That's literally, true.
Like, rock Pokemon. So it's like, are, like,
yeah.
Like, Golem just, like, is in a ball next to me. I'm like, yeah, good job. You're,
yeah,
you're,
but you're right. You're right.
Pokemon. So
it was very pointed.
Yeah. Yeah. So it's, there's a lot of evidence building up here that just doesn't quite make sense. And it's honestly, at least on my side, just a little bit disappointing because I really loved Let's Go. I thought it was just such a nice way to revisit a place that you've already been, a nice introduction to people who don't want to play the originals. And it feels like a miss, especially if we're kind of getting to the end of Switch. And if the next version of whatever this looks like changes things up radically, it's like, I don't want to miss out on these mechanics that were really fun specifically on this device.
They are literally always doing this, though. Like, yeah. They are always teasing stuff and making us think that something's coming. And then, oh, psych, you were silly for thinking that was happening. Like, we talked about when everyone thought we were getting Pokemon Z. We talked about when everyone thought we were getting Pokemon Stars. We've talked about that on the show before. Remember, like, at the end of Pokemon Omega Ruby and Alpha Sapphire, when you got to, like, this one area, and they're like, oh, Battle Tower under construction coming soon. And we were all like, oh my god, we're getting some sort of either Emerald expansion or, like, I don't know, Gamma Emerald. I don't even know what that would be. But we always think there's something, and then it's not that thing at all. And instead they're like, oh, we were teasing Scarlet and Violet the whole time. Did you see the oranges and the grapes on the counter in the previous game? You should have known. No!
Yeah.
I have a theory on the title Pokemon ZA.
Let's hear it.
I was looking over social media, and a lot of people have pointed out that in X and Y, one of the main characters is named AZ. Remember him? He was like the mysterious, like, homeless man. And then it turned out he was the former king of the Kalos region.
Yeah.
So perhaps this, if this is the future, maybe the future king is ZA, his descendant or something like that. Who knows? But that does seem, it can't be a coincidence that AZ was a major character. And the game is called ZA, right? It has to mean something.
Yeah.
Yeah, I remember that, and I completely forgot that guy's name was Az. I forgot. I memory hold that. No, you're right.
Parents had interesting tastes.
Yeah.
All right, well.
Oh, I found what the unknown spells on Twitter. And apparently I'm not bad at reading unknown. It really does seem to be just gibberish. It's like, it's S-O-E-Y-U-E. Soyu?
New legendary.
It's not anything.
Right. Nope. It's a bit of a bummer.
Yeah. Well, it might be something. It might spell. Yeah. It might be like a new Pokemon or a new something.
Or nothing at all. It could be anything.
Remember like the Sinnoh region in Diamond and Pearl was like renamed in Legends Arceus. Maybe this I don't know, but what it doesn't compute at this time.
Well, we only have a year at least to wait to find out what all of this means. I do like how they've just basically lied through this whole thing, tricked everybody into thinking more than there really was. And I'm sure that when trailer breakdowns, I'm sure we'll do a trailer breakdown and then more information will emerge on the Legends ZA. I do like that they have my Swordy Boys Pokemon, whose name, please forgive me, I always forget. It's like my favorite Gen 6 Pokemon. But
you can't remember the name of your favorite Gen 6 Pokemon?
I'm quite ill right now. The fact that I can remember where I am is pretty amazing. Honedge, thank you. Golly. Honedge. There he is.
Well, that one's...
That's not Honedge. That's the Evolve.
Aegislash.
Thank you.
Aegislash, however you want to say.
Yeah. All right. Well, Joshua, you are an expert on basically all card games. Like, it's kind of impressive and amazing, your depth of knowledge. And
I'm glad someone finds it impressive.
Yeah. Last year in LA at the office, you and Teddy, who does contract work for us, you guys sat there and talked about, like, I think Yu-Gi-Oh! At a level that I've never heard anybody speak kind of on anything. And it was just like fascinating. And at one point you looked at me and you're like, I can't believe you're still standing here. because I watch it too. You know, it's like watching Michael Jordan and LeBron trade tips. But I want to get your take on this new trading card game that Pokemon TCG Pocket. This is coming to the phone. You crack packs like twice a day. Are you excited for this, or do you think this takes anything away from the actual card game?
It's interesting because, well, on one hand, it does actually look cool. It seems like it's aimed at people who enjoy collecting and people who appreciate the art of Pokemon. And it does look so cool that I guess for some cards, you can go into the card frame and explore the world that the art and see what's outside the border. That sounds like a really cool experience. I can't wait to do that. Awesome. That said, the Pokemon trading card game community has been pretty unpleased with the current client that we use to play the card game online, Pokemon Live. And so the fact that they're making another game that you can play the game on, but it looks like a condensed, simpler version. But I think a lot of people are going to say, this pocket app, whatever, it looks cool, fine, but can you give us a better app to play the actual game on? Because it's a little rough. It's really rough.
Is it the same app that they've been using for all the, years and years? Or is there something newer? Because I remember when both my kids were really into it, downloading that app. Is it years ago? Is it the same one?
They finally, they sunset Pokemon Trading Card Game Online and replaced it with Pokemon Live. But it's just not the same. It feels like actually several steps backwards and is missing tons of features that the old one that was 20 years old had. We're in turmoil right now. Okay. Seeing this is really cool. And I think they know that most people who buy Pokemon cards actually are not playing the game. They're collecting. So I think they're leaning into that. It said that this was co-produced by or made by DNA, who does Pokemasters EX. And all I hear when I hear that is that this is going to have a lot of gotcha mechanics or microtransactions, and it's going to really incentivize people to want to open more than two packs a day. And I'm assuming that's going to cost real world money.
Go ahead.
Do you think it looked like there was some sort of quick battle feature. Do you think there's any possibility this replaces the current live scenario?
No, I don't think so. I think I imagine when you have an app with cards on it that people will want to play a little bit. So there's giving people a way to do that on that app. But in no way does that replace the actual full-fledged app where you can play the game, normally and at a competitive level. I think that would be a terrible idea to just get rid of the actual client in favor of a quick mode.
It does also seem like an entry point for people who are really into the collecting. And it's hey, you want to play with these cards that you have collected to just try it out and then kind of get people sucked into that part of it. And that seems a lot more approachable, especially since people have known how to play Pokemon, the card game, for so long at this point. And this seems a nice way to, ease into it.
Yeah.
I think it is nice that they give you two packs per day. That feels sort of generous.
My hope is that because I haven't played the TCG in a really long time or collected or anything, but I remember years ago when I could buy a pack in real life, and then it would always have the code in it, and I would put that into the online thing, and I would be able to open a pack online as well. And so I would hope for that kind of tie-in in this, so that people who are actively already engaged in the TCG are getting something for it, as opposed to just sort of restarting their collections. Or maybe there's a way to input cards that you actually physically own. I don't know. But having to start from scratch kind of seems like it sucks. Yeah, I mean, probably not.
This looks to me like a license to print. I think that the two packs seems generous, but I think you're going to get a lot of commons. And they're, I think DNA knows exactly what they're doing. They're going to make it, you get just a little taste. Well, I might as well spend $8 to buy the, 400 Poke points so I can buy an odd number of packs or something and still have some left over. But I mean, just the way that you open them, a little slice across the top. I mean, I could just do that all day. It just looks so satisfying. It's like a digital bubble wrap Almost.
DNA also did Fire Emblem Heroes. They did Animal Crossing Pocket Camp. And I know Nintendo has been all like, oh, our mobile games didn't do very well or whatever. But both of those games got people to spend quite a bit of money. So, you know.
The one that you were just, like I said, I'm actually sick.
Animal Crossing Pocket Camp, Fire Emblem Heroes.
The Fire Emblem Heroes, thank you. I wanted to say Dragon Warrior, but that's an NES game. Fire Emblem, I actually kind of got into that, and it was pretty thrilling. And I noticed here on the card game that they do have the sort of the diamond level rarity. And like, I remember getting like a rare hero in Fire Emblem and being all excited, even though I ended up just completely falling off that game, not playing at all. But yeah, I think this might be successful with a more, like Joshua, like you're saying, like a collector audience, but probably not for the hardcore, card game community out there. But all right. That was the Pokemon TCG Pocket. There's party hats coming to Pokemon Go for Pokemon Day.
So that's be a Pokemon Day unless we got some party hat Pokemon in Go. Yeah.
And those are out right now. And then there's Pikachu with Caps Hat. Big Hat Day.
Big Hat Day.
Yeah. So if you want Caps Hat, you can start that with the Pokemon Go collab event. Terror Raid Battle events begin tomorrow. What have I missed? Masters. Oh, this was a fun one. Masters EX celebrates 4.5 years. Like, all right. That's just kind of how like we're celebrating 700 shows. So, all right.
This is our 700th show.
This is our 700th episode of Nintendo Voice Chat.
Yay, Pokemon!
Yeah, I know. It kind of fell on a cool day that we get to do a live show, even though everyone's really tired and I'm sick. But all right, we've kind of spoken on this during the course of our conversation, but I want to know, were your expectations met or were they not, and kind of how do you feel overall about this? Reb, I'd like to start with
you. So I've said a lot of things about my feelings about this. I think Legend ZA is a really interesting surprise. I like that it wasn't what I expected. I'm only bummed out that we didn't get Johto because it was teased the whole show. I didn't actually walk in here expecting Let's Go Johto, so it's okay. I'm kind of wondering where the Black and White remakes are, or if we're ever going to get those. I mean, there were never any promises we were going to. It was just a community thing, but like, it would be great if we did. I think my actual genuine... So when we were talking through how the show was going to go, everybody was asking me, okay, what do you think we're going to see at Pokemon Presents? And what I said was, we're probably going to open with some sort of like middle of the road kind of like spin-off game, like a Mystery Dungeon or a Pokemon Snap size and style of game. We're going to get a bunch of mobile game updates, and then we're going to have the big, okay, here's what their next big Pokemon game is. And I was almost right, except we didn't have that first thing. We didn't have some sort of like Pokemon tournament, like spin-off kind of thing in the opening. And as a result, the coming year actually feels kind of empty of Pokemon. Like, we don't have a big spinoff. We don't have a big Pokemon game coming till next year. We have all these mobile updates. And that's fine. Like, most big series don't just churn things out every single year at the cadence that the Pokemon company tends to. But given their history, it's a little weird that this is a slower year for Pokemon. And so I don't know that I'm disappointed per se, but it's interesting. It's notable. I hope this means they're hunkering down and focusing on getting their crap together, because Scarlet and Violet were kind of disappointing.
Mm-hmm. All right. Fair enough. Joshua, how are you feeling? Were your expectations met?
I thought I was pleasantly surprised. I didn't expect a new game, like a new Legends game of all things. So I am excited to find out more about that. I thought Legends Arceus was a really good concept, but much like Scarlet and Violet, I thought it was lacking in execution in a lot of ways. So I hope that they've taken some lessons there and are improving. I'm actually fine with them taking a little bit of a break this year, although there's still tons of other Pokemon stuff coming out. Not big releases, but you know, the Pokemon machine goes on. The quality of the past couple major releases has not been there, so I hope they're taking this time to make sure the next releases do get there and exceed expectations in terms of quality. I was kind of hoping a little bit for, you know, remakes of Black and White, because honestly, I think that's the last great Pokemon game, like that generation, Gen 5. it's so good, and I was interested to see what they might be doing with the remake, but also felt a little too soon for that, so I didn't have, you know, big expectations to see that again. And yeah, I was not expecting a new Pokemon trading card game app. And like I said before, I do think it's cool, and I'm interested to explore it and go into the card art and stuff like that. But I feel like I have to wonder, like, is that coming at the expense of the actual app where you can play the full game, which is completely just like under developed and is missing tons of features and feels really clunky to play. And it just feels like, well, cool for collecting, but can we improve the playing experience?
If Kat Bailey were here, she would remind us that Pokemon is turning into more of a lifestyle brand than a video game brand, and I think she's right.
Oh, I don't think it's turning.
It is. It already is.
It is, 100%.
That. Yeah. Correct. But.
All right, Miranda, how are you feeling? Were your expectations met?
I'm pretty sleepy, and we're getting legendaries in Pokemon Sleep, so I'm actually really happy about that. I know I keep coming back to this, but that was my main expectation, was I wanted some cool little thing for Pokemon Sleep. And I knew we were going to get mobile updates that like happens every year. And so it's cool to see them continuing to support that, because it is such a weird like game. Like, as Reb just said, like, and that has Kat has alluded to, Pokemon is sort of like a lifestyle company. It kind of always has been, honestly. Like, I think for a very long time, they've tried to like, hey, do you want this plate? And I'm like, yeah. Yeah, I do. But I think I came in with really low expectations, because as other folks have mentioned, it does feel like a little bit of a down year, and especially kind of gauging where the Nintendo Switch is in its life cycle, I think it's a good time for them to sort of take a beat. I could see us getting, well, I guess I was surprised that we're getting Pokemon Legends next as the next spinoff, but I could see that being maybe an early-ish next year release as sort of like a, oh, this is our capstone on the Nintendo Switch. Yeah. Like, it's our final major Pokemon release on the Nintendo Switch as it is. And then us moving on to the next thing. And in a way too, I think also with us getting a brand new Pokemon anime series with new leads, like Ash has had his journey, Ash and Pikachu are off on the sunset doing their own thing. This does really feel like a weird like reset for Pokemon.
Mm. Yeah, a little bit.
And getting that beat to just say like, all right, we're going to continue on with what we have. This new show is a big focus for us, and we're going to work on continuing to develop, as we said, like the bigger lifestyle part. Next year is like when we go full force, maybe with different announcements or other things. And as Reb has said too, it's like really nice for them to have a bit of a break, just because, and Josh has also said this, like the quality of Scarlet and Violet wasn't really what we were looking for, I think, from mainline Pokemon games. And even Pokemon Legends Arceus, like, I think it was really cool, but it was an ugly game. So
I
think it's just time. It's just time for us to get that Pokemon reset, get everybody a little bit of a break, and then keep on going with what's to come.
Yeah, I think that's fair. A Pokemon reset is good. Reb,
I don't mean to divert us, but Nintendo of America just dropped a tweet for the trailer for Pokemon Legends ZA, and their phrasing is, watch to see the reveal trailer for Pokemon Legends ZA, a new adventure set entirely within Lumiose City.
Okay. Interesting.
Yeah. I don't know how to unpack that further, but that's an interesting piece of information.
Well, that's more information than they gave us in the trailer.
The trailer, so,
yeah. I mean, as my feelings are, you know, it's not a huge Pokemon enjoyer, but I do enjoy Pokemon. I have played several of the games, but only one have I ever finished, and that was Blue. But it was fine. It was probably like a 7 out of 10. Joshua.
No, are you referring to the Pokemon Presents being a 7
the
out of 10 or Blue?
The Presents.
Yeah. I think Joshua was reacting to the possibility the Pokemon of you presents. Ranking Pokemon Blue a 7 out of 10.
No, Pokemon Blue was, the first one I had was Yellow. I never beat it because I got stuck in whatever in a save loop, but played it on the Wii U virtual console. But my biggest surprise and my biggest sort of disappointment was you still can't play the original Game Boy Pokemon or Game Boy Advance games on your Nintendo Switch. Like, I kind of was just expecting they were going to say, now you can play.
Put them on virtual console,
yeah. Yeah, like
Not virtual console,
yellow, blue, and red on Nintendo Switch online.
Online, yeah.
Like, yeah.
Don't know why we can't do that, because you have to play them either on your 3DS or your Wii U, which nobody's doing, or like break out the original one, which is...
Wait, aren't they on the virtual console?
Sorry, they're on the virtual console.
They're on virtual console, but they're not on Nintendo Switch online.
Yeah.
So.
Oh, right.
If I had to guess, they're not putting red, blue, and yellow on there because they have Let's Go, Pikachu, and Eevee, and they want to keep selling copies of that.
I mean, sure, but they also want to sell Nintendo Switch Online service, which costs them very little and costs you $20 a year. So, I don't know. It was a fine presents. The Legends at the end was a big, definitely a surprise. I don't think anybody really fully expected that. And I think no one's expectations were fully met with this presents, especially just going off of what, well, okay, with the exception of Miranda, which shout out.
To be clear, I had the lowest. Just after like the pacing of everything that's been released, I was like,
yeah,
this is gonna be a quiet year. I love Pokemon Day. I honestly do. But also I was like, this is one I could have slept in a little bit for and watched later and been happy with it.
Yeah.
Miranda's gonna Pokemon sleep well tonight.
Nice. Yeah. Get those Seth, extra what would get you to play like a new Pokemon game? Like what would they have had to show today for you to be like, yeah, I'm gonna buy that and play Pokemon again?
Good. Hearing what you said about the game is going to take completely within Lumio City. And then, yeah, the trailer did have like a urban redevelopment plan, right? And it seemed like you're going to be building and designing your own like Pokemon city. That there are games like that, like, you know, city builders. If that's what this is, like you're not just like going around battling, but you're actually like building out the city. That actually sounds really cool, right? There's a ton of games that have done that, but Pokemon hasn't really done that, right?
Mm-hmm. No, yeah. I don't think they have. No.
That would be pretty awesome. Go ahead.
No, they haven't done that. No, I was trying to remember like this one mechanic in Black 2 and White 2, but it wasn't that. So
I feel like this is like Sim City, but it's like Pokemon City. Yeah. That sounds cool.
I'd be into that.
You've basically only been able to decorate like rooms and very small scope things.
Secret
but
bases.
Yeah, that would be really neat. Yeah, secret bases.
Yeah.
You know, like secret cities. What if you could design your own like series of Pokemon gyms or something like that? You get to choose the types and stuff. I don't know. I'm really going off in another direction here, but it does seem like that, right? I can think of like in Assassin's Creed, right? There's like a city that you would develop over time and add new features and stuff. That's the first one that comes to mind, but there are a lot of games like that. If that's what this is, that would be cool.
Don't say anything you want them to do, because then you guarantee they will not do it.
But
Seth, what would get you to play a Pokemon game?
Well, city building now. Like, I would definitely like, super want that. I've played all of the Pokemons that have come out since, you know, whenever the 3DS.
But we can finish one.
I just never finished. I never finished.
That's true.
I've started finishing games now that I have been properly diagnosed with ADHD.
How's Tears of the Kingdom going?
I haven't beat Tears of the Kingdom because I don't want that game to end.
Exactly.
It's different than me just like seeing something shiny float by my window and going and chasing it into the woods. Like, I don't know. You know what would make me finish is just like sitting down and saying, I'm going to finish this Pokemon game. Maybe I'll try Scarlet and Violet. I have them both. No.
There is some good Pokemon in there, though, and some characters are really nice.
The time I had with it, I enjoyed.
Pokemon's fantastic.
I think one of the problems that I have with getting hooked by a game like,
my shiny Palmy. Like, come on, guys. Like, there's some redeemable thing. It's not.
I gave it a 7. I liked a lot of parts of it.
It just had a lot of performance.
No, I gave it a 6. I gave Arceus 7. Sorry. I can't keep track anymore.
Yeah, I wouldn't point people toward it, though. I'd be like,
I still
is
like
this the one you have to play? No.
It's fun. It's fine. I think for me, having been a grown adult when Pokemon hit, and I did when I was in the Air Force and I was in Germany, the only thing we had on TV, because we had like one station, the Armed Services Network, after I got home from work, was Pokemon animated series, and I would just sit there and watch it because there's like nothing else on. And then I played Pokemon Yellow on my Game Boy on like deployments and stuff, but I don't have that sort of nostalgia. I think that had I been younger and it hit me, that would make a 3D Pokemon as impactful as seeing all these games that I've only known pixel art, which I love. I love Pokemon.
Yeah.
I love the chiptunes, but seeing them brought into the 3D world doesn't quite feel like it has that same impact for me, and therefore I don't have that same level of disappointment that it is a little janky and nasty. So you know what? I'm gonna go back and try to finish one of those two games.
There honestly, it is. If you ask me, I think when Pokemon went 3D in X and Y, I think that's where the main series kind of started taking a nosedive. So really, you got out at a great time.
I don't know that I'd say nosedive, because I do like a lot of things about some of the games since that. Like, I really enjoyed Sun and Moon.
I really liked Sun and Moon. Like, those are the last ones I think I really loved.
But I do think I agree with the sentiment that Pokemon hasn't quite been the same since then. And I think Game Freak are very much masters of the pixel art and kind of the old style, like, top-down RPG situation. Oh, yeah. And I think a lot of those monster designs are not as cool when you make them into 3D models. Like, they were not originally envisioned as smooth, shiny 3D models.
Yeah. Some like of them. The episode of The Simpsons where Homer goes 3D. It just looks weird.
This looks a little weird. Yeah. But some of the newer ones, because they're designing Pokemon with that intention now, are, we're doing
Which
okay.
Is fair enough. And then like X and Y, you have the little training mini game, I guess, and those little guys are and I love that because they like bounce around and stuff. So maybe I'll just get, I have my 3DS. I found all my carts. Maybe I'll go back and I'll finish X.
Yeah,
do that and see where that leads.
You get roller skates in that game.
Yeah, that's
right. I hope we get roller skates again.
That's okay. So let me ask real quick then, what do you think Pokemon needs to do to get it back to where it was for you?
So the reason I said that, six is where it all started going downhill for me. And I think Gen 5 is the last great Pokemon game. Oh my God, is that a Ditto? Ah, how long has that been there? what was I saying? Oh, I think 5, it was the last game that felt challenging, right? There was like a grind there. But starting with X and Y, they made the games like so easy and like too narrative driven, where it would take over the game for you, is letting these scenes play out and showing you exactly where to go. It just feels like the game lost what made it interesting. And I haven't lost a Pokemon battle since X and Y. And I'm not saying that because I'm great at Pokemon battling on the video game side. I'm definitely not. But if they've made it accessible and easy for everyone. Unfortunately, sales for the games since then have gone up. Gen 5 was, I think it's the lowest selling generation. So they probably will never go back to games the way they used to be, because they've just gotten more and more popular and more successful and sold more units. The more they've made it, them 3D and accessible, AKA like easier. So I do feel like if they made a more like kind of like hardcore game, or at least gave us a difficulty setting, that would be amazing. Like, can I at least get some gym leaders that cover their weakness again? That would be great.
I kind of disagree with that perspective. Like, I do think there's been discussion about the way EXP share affects the game and various other things, but I do think more recent games are easier to play through the base story than, say, Red and Blue. Like, you go back and fight that Elite Four and you're like, oh God. But I mean, that's just because the audience has expanded for Pokemon, right? And I think that's okay. What I love about Pokemon is that it does have more challenging aspects for people who want them. Apart from the fact that the raids don't really work in Scarlet and Violet, when the raids do work, they can be really challenging and fun. And some of the later game battles can be very challenging and fun. And some of the legendary battles can be too, especially if you're just playing through for the first time and you're not rolling through with like this team of level 100s that you've EV trained all the heck. And you have the competitive battle scene as well on top of that. So if you're really into the mechanics of Pokemon, like they remain complex and interesting and you're able to take on these difficult challenges against other people through PvP. And so I like that they've combined those two aspects. They have the easier story mode for people who just want to catch their Pokemon and have a good time. But then if you want to seek out greater challenges, you can. And I think that's one of the really wonderful things they've done with the series. If I could have anything apart from games that just function on a basic level, I would like to see them go back to the sort of sense of adventure that they had in some of the older games. I felt like there were secrets behind every corner. I felt like after I beat the game, there were new areas that were unlocked to explore and new interesting things popping up. And I think some of that is just hurt by the transition to 3D. But in Scarlet and Violet, it very much felt like I was just running through these empty grassy fields and I would walk around a corner and be like, oh, it looks like there's something cool over here. And it was just a Pokeball. It was nothing. It was not exciting. And so I would like to return to that sense if it's possible.
So you want to feel that same sense of wonder that you felt.
Maybe that's asking too much. Yeah, I think it was easier in like. It was easier when you were looking at this sort of 2D pixelated world, right? Because you had this really beautiful small scale rendition of what this was. And then in my imagination, it was much bigger, but now they've actually made it bigger. Like in the game, it is so much bigger. And it turns out that it's probably very challenging to fulfill that fantasy.
Well, I mean, making it. Probably maybe one of my favorite things about Breath of the Wild Tears of the Kingdom is how successfully
yeah,
it adapted that 2D world that I loved as a little kid into a fully realized 3D world. I don't think
that's true.
Pokemon has been able to do that yet. But to their credit, we're talking about freaking Nintendo and Zelda. Like, obviously, like, nobody's ever.
I don't know. Pokemon's got. They've got budget. Like, they can.
I mean, yeah, sure. They've got the budget, but like.
If they chose to take their time and really. I believe they can do it. I believe it is possible. I just think that the money machine is cranking.
Yeah. But Zelda was extremely successful for the Nintendo, that Nintendo company.
Yeah, I mean, Pokemon already has tried to make like their version of Zelda with Legends Arceus, right? That's essentially Pokemon by way of Breath of the Wild, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. So they kind of have done that. But actually, you saying that, Seth, made me think, what if they did make a Pokemon game that was as good as Zelda? What if they weren't on seemingly a very rigid release schedule where they just churn out these games and they're not as good as they could be? What if we got a truly amazing Pokemon game? And I hate to bring up Pal World, but a lot of people have really taken to that game because it's done so many things and innovative and use the creatures in a way that Pokemon never has in ways that they really want to. And I'm not just talking about shooting them with guns. and so I think Pokemon does have to take a good hard look at that and think, well, what can we do to innovate and make our games better? Because for me, at least, if they feel trapped in the past and I want a modern Pokemon masterpiece, give it to me.
Yeah, 100%. Yeah. Miranda, do you have anything to add?
Yeah, I have been thinking about this a lot as far as like difficulty and what sort of experiences you actually get from a mainline Pokemon game. And I think I side a little bit more with Rep on the difficulty. Like, I think there are challenges and I think it'd be nice to see more of those as an option. Sure. And it's weird because like really what I want from Pokemon games is like more, which is weird to say, but like I want more experiences with my Pokemon. Like I want to actually be able to play with them again in a meaningful way. Like Scarlet and Violet was like a really bad attempt at that with their little picnic system, and it felt like such a step back from all the things they've done in different games to give you opportunities to have time with your Pokemon aside from battling. And that's I think something I've looked for a lot. And I think as far as like the difficulty goes, I like that it's not too grindy or too challenging in some points because I get to play with the team that I formed that may not necessarily be the best competitively, but they're like, they're my pals. Like, I genuinely love my Pokemon. Like, they are, like, I catch the same Pokemon every time if I can. I'll, like, trade them in if I have to. Like, they are my team, and, like, I want to go on this adventure with them every time if I can with some new friends. But at the same time, like,
Cat in the frame, by the way, if you're watching the video.
That's my, yeah, my real life Pokemon. That's your real life. Ari.
Well, I think I'm going to split the difference. I think personally, I would love, yeah, like more Pokemon activities. But like Joshua, like you're saying, maybe expand on that, that whole mechanic. You know, Breath of the Wild, Tears of the Kingdom, they did things that Zelda games had never done before. Like the building mechanic in The Legend of Zelda, Tears of the Kingdom is the most, like, memed and shared and most probably talked about mechanic in that whole game, and it's basically entirely new. So, you know, is the answer Pokemon with guns? Well, Pal World maybe thinks so, but something a little bit different that keeps that core feeling of collecting and evolving and making friends with these, and then make the world bigger, make the world more expansive, make the world more immersive. I think that would be a bajillion-dollar property. But again, like you're saying, Joshua, that they have to have these come out every year, and that makes them a little rushed. Whereas Tears of the Kingdom, they had a video come out specifically to say, sorry, it's not where we want it to be yet. We're going to take another year, and look what we got, the best game of all time. But I have some bad news. That is all the time we have left for this week's Nintendo
Voice. Great transition.
Thank you. Before we go, I have a few favors to ask. This is also the slowest I've ever read this. If you're watching us on YouTube, please just leave us a like and a nice comment. If you're listening to us on a podcast app, please leave us a review. It helps us spread the good NVC word, and we will be forever in your debt. Reb, Joshua, Miranda, I want to thank you all, the Elite Three, for waking up so damn early. I'm going to let you all go and get some more coffee. I'm going to go back to bed because I'm sick. But remember, NVC is the only place where you can
get the thing.
Get the thing.
Get
the
thing.
You got to get. I'm going to get a coffee. That's the thing.
Please take care.